In this video, we are going to learn how to program this very tiny member of Arduino family, that is Arduino Pro Mini, with the help of FTDI. We will study why we should use Arduino Pro Mini when we already have Arduino Uno available, and what is the need of using another piece of hardware to program. So without any further delay, let's get started. If you are planning to work with Arduino and develop amazing electronics projects, then all you have to do is to press the subscribe button and enjoy various other tutorials that are specifically designed for both beginners and advanced level users. Hello everyone and welcome to Engineering Online. Before going deep into this, let's have a brief introduction of Arduino Pro Mini. It performs almost same functions as all other Arduino boards. It is mainly different from other boards in terms of its size, voltage regulation and clock speed. Now when we compare Arduino Uno with Arduino Pro Mini, we realize that its size is 1/6 the size of Arduino Uno. That is why it is named as Pro Mini, and its small size makes it useful for most of the projects. Arduino Uno has two voltage regulators, that is 3.3 volts and 5 volts, while Arduino Pro Mini has only one. It has two main versions. First version has 5 volt regulator and 16 MHz clock speed, whereas second version has 3.3 volt regulator and 8 MHz clock speed. Now which version you would be using, it depends upon your application. Now let's look at the pin configuration of Arduino Pro Mini. It has 80 mega 328 microcontroller to take all the decisions. It has 14 digital I/O pins, from which 6 pins are used for pulse width modulation. It also has 8 analog input pins with 10-bit resolution. If you closely observe the regulator labeling, the text KB33 shows that it is 3.3 volt version and KB50 shows that it is 5 volt version. You can also measure this voltage between VCC and ground pin. Then we have two ground pins on the board. Next we have TX and RX pins. These pins are used in serial communication, where TX represents the transmission of serial data and RX represents the receiving data. VCC is the regulated voltage and it can be 5 volt or 3.3 volts. Raw pin is used to supply raw voltage to the board, and it is mainly connected with the unregulated power supply within the range of 5 volts to 12 volts. Next we have reset pins, and it is set to low voltage to reset the board if it hangs up in the middle of any process. These 6 pins are actually connected with the FTDI board to program Arduino Pro Mini. Apart from voltage regulation and size, what makes it different from other Arduino boards is that it does not have a USB port to program it from the computer. Since all of the USB circuitry has been removed from it, that is why it is quite compact and smallest among others. Now the question arises how to program this board. For this purpose, we will use a FT232RL FTDI USB serial module. It is quite handy and mostly preferable. This module has 6 pins that would be connected with Arduino Pro Mini. Let's have a brief description of these pins. First one is data terminal ready. It is an output pin used for the flow control. Then we have RX, that is serial data receive pin. Then we have TX, serial data transmit pin. VCC is positive voltage output. It is controlled by the jumper. If the jumper is set to 5 volts, then it provides 5 volt output. And if the jumper is set to 3.3 volts, then it provides a 3.3 volt output. CTS is clear to send. It is an input pin used for flow control. And last we have is the ground pin. Now let's connect the Arduino Pro Mini with FTDI. The connections are quite easy. The DTR pin is connected to the DTR pin. The TX is connected to the RX and RX is connected to the TX. The VCC pin is connected to the VCC pin. The ground pin is connected to the CTS pin, and another ground pin is connected to the ground pin of FTDI. Now we will do the same connections on hardware also. So connections are completed. Now connect the mini USB cable with FTDI and let's program it with Arduino IDE. Here I am trying to run a simple blink program to blink the onboard LED of Arduino. So open a blink program from the examples. Change the board settings to Arduino Pro or Pro Mini. Change processor settings to 80 Mega 328P 3.3 volts and 8 MHz. And programmer settings to Arduino as ISP. Click on the upload to upload the program on the board. Where there is an issue, the port is not detected. It usually happens when the FTDI board is not detected by the PC due to driver issues. So let's verify it by opening the device manager. The FT232R USB UART drivers are not updated. Click on the update driver. It will ask you to search for the drivers. There are two options, either search automatically from the internet or browse it locally from the computer. I am searching it online. You can also find the FTDI drivers from the Arduino folder. So my drivers have been updated. Change the port to COM4. Now upload the program on the board and it is a success. The onboard LED is now blinking. Well, that was a simple blink program. You can do any project with this compact and tiny Arduino board that requires less space. Its small size and ease of use makes it stand out among all other boards where space is the main concern. So if you are developing a small and compact size project, then Arduino Pro Mini is a must try. After programming it with FTDI, you can remove it and power Arduino Pro Mini with external power supply. Now try it on your own and provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. I hope that you must have learned from this video. You can do many more exciting projects with Arduino Pro Mini. That was all for today. Do like the video and share it with your friends and fellows. Subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative videos. Plus, you can also connect with us on Facebook and Instagram. Links are added in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time with another amazing tutorial.